The class itself is pretty popular with students, and I think a lot of it is because it's a different type of class. It's not your typical come in, take notes, and read out of a book thing. The Biodome class came about a few years ago. Another teacher and myself, we talked about wanting to have a greenhouse to kind of do some extended activities. And now it's swayed more into a botany course where, in a horticulture type course, where we're actually teaching students how to do the garden planning and also the extra stuff of, you know, what the plants need and how they need it.
Tomatoes, cucumbers, anything like that.
Strawberries, peanuts. There's a lot of them. I just love eating all types of vegetables.
This tank is used for fertilizing the dome. We use it with our irrigation system. The vermiponics systems here, two different systems that two different groups of students design. We have them underneath the grow lights so that we can hopefully produce plants all year long. I've always told my students the goal is to have strawberries at Christmas time. We have our strawberry beds back here. These have been established in here since the dome was started back in 2010. Then we've added in some herbs along the way. What we have is our lemon tree and our small lime tree. We have a variety, six different varieties of apples in here. And one of the things that we try to do too is stay away from a lot of the commercial type growing systems as well. So it's showing them that with the materials that they have around themselves, they can really do the aquaponics or the hydroponics with a little ingenuity and be able to do that on their own scale at home.
The A-frames where the hydroponics are, I thought that was cool because I always thought you'd have to plant it like in the ground, but I guess you can plant them in pipes too and it works the same.
I think it's changed a lot of kids thinking of, hey, I can do this. This isn't that hard. It's not that, you know, big of a deal.
Seeing the way that it's grown here versus at stores, like I've always thought about like the pesticides and stuff they use is not healthy, where now that I know you can get it organic like from the Biodome where there's no pesticides or anything used. Yeah, it's influenced a lot of my diet. So we eat a lot more now. Every dinner, we have at least one. Usually they're steamed.
There's a lot more vegetables in the cafeteria from here, and they actually taste better, I think, if they're from the Biodome.
This year, we just really started to integrate, okay, what he has so we can use it in the cafe. Next year, we are looking at a growing schedule. 1 month, it'll be garden vegetables, which is what we're featuring this month. 1 month, it'll be herbs. 1 month, it'll be berries. 1 month, it's root vegetables, so just kind of depending on what he can grow.
It's rewarding to know that you're giving back and that the kids are getting something that's not full of pesticides and other chemicals.
You know, they're teenagers, they're gonna eat their pizza and drink their pop and stuff, but some sort of small scale there is that change in the thinking that, hey, I can do this, I can produce this myself without having to rely on the store or spend the money at the store to do it, and really end up feeding themselves and their families.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.